Here we go once again, halfway point of this men's 3 metre springboard final. Javier Lana missing in round three, I'm afraid, so the Spaniard's challenge has faltered.
And he missed this in the prelims, just scored 51 points on the inward 3.5, 3.4 degree of difficulty. Well, that's a lot better, but still just missing the entry a fraction, coming out too early, dropping about 5 degrees short. Gets the right takeoff though, good strong push, there's the throw, ugly tuck though, knees too far apart, but it's the entry just reacting a little too early, needs to stay in the tuck a fraction longer just to bring the feet up a little bit more for a vertical entry.
71.40, and in today's exalted company that simply isn't good enough. You can't fault what Jack Law has done so far. 8th position for the World Junior Champion. Still maturing as a diver. Still finding that dive list that will give him the tariffs to compete for medals.
This is reverse 2.5. Oh, that's great. Well, on the end of the diving ball perfectly. Jumps up in the air. He's always in control. There's the first somersault. Looks for the second somersault. Reaches back. Gets a good feel on the hands. Well, he scored 72 points in the prelim, and this is a much better reverse 2.5. And as you said, these dives will be getting harder as he gets stronger.
76.50. Well done to Jack Law. Putting a phenomenal final together. Brian Nixon. He too, by his standards, just missing on a couple of rounds, and that's left him in 10th.
3.5, most difficult dive for him. Oh, he's back on the end of the diving board, struggling there, and then kicks out too late. Well, he's way back, and you see, back from the end, board feels heavy. He's struggling as going around. He's feeling that he's not going to make it. He's pulling the knees apart to increase the rotation, but he just kicks his feet up to the ceiling, and it rides right over. So you can see the strain on his face. He feels completely uncomfortable, feet flat in that tuck position. And he's now needs to react a lot sooner, kick out earlier, which he didn't do.
Yeah, consistency for some of the divers fading. Sub 60 points for Brian Nixon. What a competition this man's had. Yael Castillo already has a medal in the kit bag, but would dearly love an individual medal.
He got that bronze with his partner in the synchro event. This a back 2.5 somersault pikes, so it's down on degree of difficulty. Oh, very slow. Stopped his arms in front of his face before going into the pike. Legs came up very slow. It must have felt just like a back dive pike spinning around. So very slow, kicks out early and then short. So he needed to swing his arms back further to get the somersault moving at the beginning. He didn't make the right adjustment at the end. So another missed dive.
Yeah, 49.50. That has blown Castillo's chances in this final. Comparison time again now. Rossay Kuznetsov-Prigorov with the same dive. This is the man that set round three alight, going over 100 with his superb forward 4.5.
Always back on the end.
But oh, it's another reasonable finish.
Yeah, just see the feet come apart as he goes through the water, and the judges will pick that up. Struggling there on the takeoff, still up in the air. So uncomfortable feeling going around. Knees coming apart just to increase the rotation. Chin's up in the wrong position. Should have the head forward in the tuck, but gets a vertical entry, but with the feet apart.
71.75, and all that good work of the last round has gone for Rossay. Is this Kuznetsov's chance? Same dive, so 3.5 on the tariff. If he can nail this, he's only down in sixth, and there's not many marks in it between the top positions.
He missed one dive in the prelim, and it was this dive. Needs it now.
No. Long travel down the pool. He still made that look like a good effort.
Yeah, he was aiming for the car park, I think. He came out very straight, though. So, good entry. There, you just see the knees crimp a little bit as he comes off the diving board. That caused the travel forward. But a good comeback, good save. Maybe in the 70s? Whoa, he's got up into
well
the
done.
80s.
Well done, Kuznetsov 84. 324-30 already. And that's for a diver mid-table. Prigorov, same again. And, well, we keep saying it, this guy's a very tall diver. He's a big diver. This is a lot of dive to get round.
Good takeoff. Or Archie on the kick out. Well, that's not going to help him move back down to 11th place. Qualified in 6th. Slightly on the corner there, and he's travelling towards the other 3 metre. I'm not sure that that be picked up by the judges, but the out certainly will. The triple there. Kick, no, loose back, feet apart, feet moving around, low scores.
Yes, indeed. 6.5 down to 5.5 for 68.25. Prigorov will stay where he is.
Well, you need to do better than that if you want to get a medal.
Halfway stage in the competition as Coach Scoggins looks on his charge. Troy DeMay about to dive. Fourth position, and for the medal contenders, of which Troy is obviously one, having medaled in this event before, each of these final three rounds has to be spot on.
Yeah, and he's in a good position too. He's just at 11.45 behind first place, and we know that he's a world champion material, having 2 silvers. Big dive now, inward 3.5. Oh, he's done it again. Same thing as in the prelims, just drops out of it, finishes slightly short, and he's missed that opportunity, and he's really fed up as well. Takeoff's good, spinning well, but there, needed to stay in the tuck longer, came out into a pike too soon, and just misses that entry. There's the pike too early, head down, and doesn't fully extend on the entry.
That might be costly. Oh, it is very costly. 64.60 with DeMay's tariff being a little lower than the other medal contenders. That's going to hurt him. Now, I don't want to tee anyone up for a fall, but Julian Sanchez, after a good start to this competition, hasn't looked comfortable since, and this is a huge dive to have to face under those circumstances.
Yeah, front 4.5. Again, changed the dive. Was a 3.5 in the prelims, of which he scored 75 points on. This is 3.8. Oh, he's missed it. He came out at the right time, but the arms were in the wrong place, and he hit the back of his shoulders as he went in the water. So it was going well here, spinning fast. Well, quad just underneath the board level, but then just lines up for the wrong part of the water. Head could be forward a little bit more, but he's spinning well. He had time to come out and just reaches, well, about 40 centimetres under his body rather than forward to get the entry. 51.30, should have stuck with a 3.5 pike.
Yeah, damage done for Sanchez. Twister then for Zakharov, third position at the moment, but if he wants to get it, chin and heat, has to keep diving into the 80s at least. Oh, well, it's okay. It looked a little messy through the air, Chris.
Yeah, messy on takeoff. Steps back in the hurdle step. The dive is travelling forward. Good throw, though. But the head is in the wrong position on the twist, and the feet a little loose going through the water. So he hardly got any pike at all on the first part of the somersault. And he's relaxing too early. That's why the feet are moving apart as he hit.
76.50. It's a good score, but it's not good enough to challenge for gold and silver, really. That is all, of course, subject to how well Chin Kai and He Chong dive, but their marks in the prelims and the semi-finals indicate that they just get better and better.
Yeah, I would have thought at this point there'd be 25 points in the lead, but not 10. Anyway, Quinn has just a 2-point lead over He. This, an inward 3.5 somersaults. Oh, fantastic entry. I thought that just as he came off the ball, his hips moved back, but only a little bit. But then in the air, very tight compact tuck, and an impressive entry. Just a small movement back, triple at board level, pikes out of the tuck. And that is impressive to be able to do that, spin that fast.
96.90. It takes your breath away. And Chin Kai confirms his place in top spot, subject to what Hee Chong can do. Massive third round dive from Hee Chong to put himself back in the mix. And a big twister here in round four, 3.4 degree of difficulty.
Yeah, well, he'll need 99 points to go ahead, and he scored 96.90 in the prelim on this dive. A forward 2.5 somersaults, double twist, 3.4. So matching the same degree difficulty as the inward 3.5. Powerful jump. He's high.
Oh, yes.
Good entry. It's going to be close again. Well, I can't call it between the two of them. That was really great takeoff. Very fast spin, then into the double twist, piking out, open pike out above the 3 meter. He makes this dive look so easy. He has got enough height to add another twist to that. Plenty of time for the lineup, and just doesn't quite catch a hand on the water correctly. Left arm on top of the head, right fist pulled in against the chest. Head just a little bit down, but he's coming around now for the pike position.
For 96.90, so he doesn't make any ground on Chin Kai, but the sort of finish that we were expecting to see in this competition is gradually materialising. So it's Chin Kai in first position, Hee Chong in silver medal position, and Ilya Zakharov just ahead of Yevgeny Kuznetsov, who did himself a lot of favours in that last round, but they've still got to find some 30 points to get back in touch with China if they want to take away gold or silver. Fantastic competition continues at a pace. Round 5 and 6 still to go, but China now back in control where they want to be.